Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Canadian Stock Market Trends for Thursday, May 16th, 2013. Coming up to 7:30 a.m. on the East Coast, and stock index futures are flat while commodities are lower. So we're seeing lower prices for both gold and crude oil in the pre-market, and that's probably not good for the Canadian stock market on Thursday. We're starting to see a little divergence in the North American markets. The Mexican market has been on a sell signal for a while. The TSX traded back into the channel yesterday. We've had the VIX for the TSX on a buy signal for the last couple of days. So options traders have been trying to get ahead of the curve, looking for expecting lower prices here. A close below 12,426 would give us a new sell signal for the TSX on Thursday, and of course that would also generate a sell signal for all the ETFs that track the TSX, and of course the Horizon Beta Pro leveraged ETFs. Now the S&P 500 still looking okay. We've had a little bit of buying in the VIX over the last couple of days. Certainly had more buying in the VIX for the NASDAQ 100 over the last couple of days, but still no sign of weakness in the overall major indexes for the U.S. market. Now, I like to keep an eye on the Australian stock market when I'm analyzing the Canadian market, because I want to see how investors around the world feel about investing in commodity-related markets. And last night, the Australian market came down hard. It landed on the lower channel line but did not close below it. So we're getting pretty close to a sell signal for the Australian market. Now, when you look at the stock market, that's one aspect, of course, and then you can also look at the currency. And the currency has been getting crushed over the past month. And, you know, a lot of people are attributing that to a continued weakness in China with having a negative effect on the Australian dollar. But it also has a lot to do with what's going on in Japan. The Japanese market was down a little yesterday, but still making multi-year highs right now with the Japanese government continuing to put pressure on the Japanese yen. Now, the Canadian dollar has been down the last couple of days, and that probably has more to do with the continued strength in the U.S. dollar than just weakness in the Canadian dollar. So I don't think anybody's picking on the Canadian dollar the way they're picking on the Australian dollar right now. It's just a reflection of overall strength in the U.S. dollar against all currencies around the world. Taking a look at commodity prices, we had a lot of volatility in the energy sector on Wednesday. Brent crude traded through the lower channel line but did not close there. West Texas crude traded below the lower channel line but came back into the channel going into the close. It's down in the pre-market this morning, so we're getting pretty close to a new buy signal on Thursday. Had a lot of volatility in gasoline, but closed at the end of the day above the upper channel line. Heating oil had a volatile day, but once again closed back in the channel. And natural gas moved right up to the upper channel line. A close above 408.30 would give us a new buy signal on Thursday for nat gas. Looking at copper, we traded below the lower channel line but did not close there. A close below 325 would give us a sell signal on Thursday. Gold continued to move lower yesterday, and it's down in the pre-market this morning. So once again, this is a very profitable time to be short gold or long the bear ETFs in this sector. Taking a look at silver, continued lower, new low yesterday for this move, and we're continuing lower this morning. So once again, the bear ETFs are the place to be for gold and silver. Next up, let's take a look at the Canadian stock market. And we talked about the TSX coming down to the lower channel line yesterday. Volume leader on Wednesday was RMP Energy, made a new high for this move, but actually closed lower on the day. Of course, I would be more concerned about this stock if it took out the previous day's low. That would certainly be a negative sign, but we just saw a little profit taking yesterday. Keep an eye on that stock. If you own that stock and you haven't taken money off the table, well, Thursday would be a good day to lock in some profits. Energy stocks closed right on the upper channel line. The next volume leader in energy yesterday was TORC Energy, already on a sell signal. We saw financial services come down hard yesterday, but closed right at the lower channel line. We saw some buying going into the close there yesterday. Manulife had an inside day on Wednesday. Gold stocks continued lower on Wednesday. KINROSS was the volume leader for gold stocks on the TSX, one of those stocks that did not generate a buy signal over the last couple of weeks. A close above 559 is required to generate a buy signal on Thursday. Looking at materials, came down hard yesterday on a sell signal, while Potash made a new high for this move on Wednesday. Metals and mining stocks traded into the channel. HudBay is now back on a sell signal. A close above 837 is required to generate a new buy signal on Thursday. Phone stocks came down hard yesterday. That had a lot to do with Rogers. Rogers was down hard yesterday. Was already on a sell signal, so no change in trend there. The venture exchange continued lower on Wednesday. Bear Creek Mining was one of those stocks leading the venture exchange lower. And last up for the Canadian stock market, Blackberry came down yesterday just above the lower channel line. A close below 1525 would give us a new sell signal on Thursday for Blackberry. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts, starting with the hourly panic zone chart for the TSX. We're still projecting lower prices here. I was hoping to get out without breaking down below the flypaper channel. We'll have to see if that area of support will hold on Thursday. We're watching the trend lines and looking for a breakout, and we actually broke down there, and of course that's negative. Currently holding the 100 and 200 hour moving average for the overall TSX, and let's hope we don't start breaking down below that on Thursday. We are trading between two channel lines, and then finally we broke down. So a move down to this area here would not be surprising on Thursday if we continue lower. The first sign of strength on Thursday for the overall Canadian stock market is an hourly close above 12,524. If you look at the financial services, you can see we had some buying into the close while we had some selling into the close for the gold index. So that's what investors were expecting going into the close on Wednesday, that we might see some buying in financial services on Thursday and some continued selling in gold stocks on Thursday. Okay, folks, that's all for Thursday morning. I'll be back Friday morning looking at the U.S. market. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you again next on Friday morning.